What's up?
What's up?
Just type it into Google, a tab, but then if it's a bit weirder, like some of the stuff we do, there's not a tab, so you gotta do it by ear, or ask Ollie.
Teaching James. Literally just play it.
When I'm learning a cover, it's all about listening to
the original
and at first trying to copy what they're doing, but then when I hear you guys play it, I have to take whatever you're emphasising the most.
For some songs I'll find actual notes, like real music, little dots, and just play it and then try and memorise it. Or other ones I'll just come up with like shorthand notes, which are just like writing what chord's playing, what time signature we're in, little things that only I can understand, like D rhythmic.
Look at my notes for invocation. D flat, E flat, F, E flat, repeat. Nursery tune, E F sharp, G F sharp, jam, Django.
Invocation, yeah, that's got to be done by ear because there's nothing for it online. So you were here while I'm learning it, I just kept playing it and repeating it. That's the main way to do covers, then which whenever you get stuck you can just look at tab.
With originals, it's sort of the same. At first I go with whatever the kind of melody, whatever is being emphasised there, and like putting bass hits or whatever, or just playing loud on certain sections either. Like, it's all about emphasis drums, it's about making everyone else sound alright and keep it all together. So, yeah.
Other stuff I'll learn just by playing by ear or because we've written it, so I can kind of remember it then, because it's a riff or it's a improvisation on chords, or it's a, it's usually, most of this stuff is kind of improvisation. Sort of bass runs between chords really. You just start with the chords, and usually like Ollie's adding kind of, he's using extended chords.
The old. Came to me, and I was like, I need to pick up a guitar player.
So I'll ask him what he's using and try and incorporate those into the bass riff somehow. And usually I'll try and write something that is kind of sounds like a classic bass riff, but then it's got sort of slightly unusual, interesting jazz inflections, I guess.
So we just kind of play them out and you just remember them from writing them. One of my favourite bits is the after. Okay, I don't know any of the names of the songs. Indigo Moon.
What's it called? Indigo Moon. In the middle section where we jam out a bit. I like to kind of go all the way up. Doing all rim stuff. Bell stuff, cowbell.
When we do the whole. And you just get to. Go for a solo for ages. Obviously that's one of my favourite bits because you just get to do what you want and do everything you know.
Probably my favourite to play is Invocation and Ritual Dance of the Young Puck.
Yeah?
Because after the initial when it kind of lets loose and the solo starts, it's just a free-for-all. You're kind of doing whatever you want. Me and Robin are just kind of, it's really driving and then drops into the Trouble Everyday riff. From the Roxy and Elsewhere. That's probably my favourite to play. Also the kind of jam on Indigo Moon. That's awesome.
Probably one of my favourite bits is the playing Grand Wazoo. Is in the actual main melody bit at the start, because I'm playing a sort of just an ordinary bass line. Just playing through the chords and running between the chords, and then it moves into the melody where I'm going. So I enjoy playing that because it's kind of, it's taking the bass to a melodic and a kind of more classic bass is the root of everything, kind of underpinning it all, and then switching to the melody is good fun.
Mm.
And that whole tune is really good fun to play because it will drive so well and there's good bass riffs in it. My favourite ones, there's the three ones that we put together, the 10th Air into Tyler Rebelli Wood into, which one's the last one? That's it, Indigo, you mean?
No,
What do we do on the third one?
I know what that is.
The one that Ollie did?
Yeah, that one.
That one.
DJ.
I like those ones for the sound of them. I enjoy playing those, but I think Divided Sky is probably the most fun to play.
The hardest one, yeah, is probably Divided Sky. Because what I'm playing is not actually that hard. It's the rhythms of that bit, like the bit before the. Oh, let's go. Before that rhythm is like, oh, what's going on here? That was wrong. don't fucking know.
Sky that I play, and it goes like this. And it was like quite difficult to begin with, but it's easy when you hear it with the chords because it follows the rhythm of that. What I found difficult was it sort of waits at the end of the bar for this. Yeah. So it was, in terms of actually playing, it's like not that difficult.
Probably my favourite song from Setlist is Divided Sky, because it has a really good mix of both kind of tight composition and kind of James can sort of improvise a little bit on the end. And there's some moments where Robin can do some kind of high kind of improvised stuff near the beginning as well. That's probably my favourite song. The bit in the middle with the dun 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 dun. Because that's, it's kind of in seven, but there's like a half beat added on the end. And pretty much how I like it with that is the bass. It's like kind of a little jump in. Dun, 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 It's like a classical piece because it's like it repeats ideas, and but not exact notes.
Divided Sky is probably the hardest physically to play because it's fast as hell and there's runs in it that are quite tricky. The bit on the start goes. That was, played that really bad. But that's pretty difficult. But then the other really difficult bit is when it goes. After that, it goes. It's something like. I don't even know how it goes, but I've got to work that out yet.
I'm not sure what it is. I think it's like an early 50s. They're all early 50s parts of Fenders, and then they've been kind of put together in a bit of a mashup by some amateur in the 60s. But it's still a pretty old, interesting. Right. Yeah, it's got a nice sound.
Thank you.
What do you think about this food, Ollie?
Very good.
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Oh. When improvising, sort of under a groove or behind a solo or something, it's difficult to kind of, because you try and make it as interesting as possible so that if you listen to the bass line on its own, it's a great thing to listen to. Without it all, and without being too repetitive or just boring. So I'm trying to make it interesting and not repetitive, but then I also don't want it to be too complicated and too wayward and you've got no idea where the hell the melody, where the hell the harmony is or whatever's going on. And so I don't want to also detract from the actual guitar solo, which is what you're going to be looking at or whatever like that.
That's the
Steve. The 11.
Oh, the 11.
Hardest thing is like not falling back into stuff you already play, like licks. Like, I'll always fall back into that, which, or that, because they work with a lot of, like that, you can just move around into any key and it works for most things. That's the hardest. Not falling back into that.
I really like the complex Afrobeat-y kind of modern jazz stuff. It's sort of more like Troika, bands like Troika and Phronesis. I enjoy playing that sort of thing, but with a kind of heavier backbeat to it, rather than just being all acoustic-y, sort of pre-written, crazy stuff. I like those complex riffs, but they're still catchy, you know what I mean? White denim style stuff. I enjoy playing Frank Zappa music, and I enjoy analysing it and trying to work out what's going on, and I think my favourite, probably, period of Zappa, because he goes through so many sort of stages, was kind of end of Mother's Invention, start of his solo career, where it was still quite, it's mental still, but there's also really good rock grooves in there and stuff where you can just really sort of jam out.
My favourite thing about Zappa is George Duke. He's just a groovy motherfucker. Inca Roads. It's just so epic. About Zappa's guitar playing is that no one plays like him. James is definitely much more Zappa influenced, so his solos and bits that he puts in, like, messy but in a good way. Constructed mess. Robin's always late.
What's that?
Cake.
Probably my favourite Zappa album is the One Size Fits All album, because that has a whole variety of different stuff going on. Also, the Grammar Zoo. I remember the first time I heard the Grammar Zoo, the track, it just was unbelievable. Cletus Ulritus, this one. This big one. This would be a good one for us to do.
Makes it a bit hard.
Yeah.
We can't do
any Zappa stuff.
Can't do a Keaton Zappa.
But also Zappa, just the stuff he was doing outside of music as well. And his general ideas towards what music should be.
But then Zappa overall, there's not enough time for this.
I can go with favourite albums. There's the one that I only heard it like the other day, the first time, Sleep Dirt. Especially the first track is well good. Burnt Weenie Sandwich, that one, especially the theme, the guitar playing in that is awesome, the sound is unreal. Hot Rats, because that is awesome. Favourite Ike Willis thing is the... Sucking on each other's dicks. That bit. That's my favourite Ike Willis thing.
Little Dots came about because we knew Andrew through the Mua festival that happened last year, and then that summer he asked if we would be interested in doing Little Dots as a cover for that album.
Buy that. That one there. Zoom in on that. It's nice.
And then we spent 2 months, first of all with Ollie, just learning all the rhythm.
It was hard to reproduce live because there's so much layering and
we overdubbed the crap out of it and made it sound good.
Sort of weird transitioning.
There's so much improvisation and playing off what other people are doing, so you've got to be really aware of what's going on.
Over each other, it's just like manic, but it's all, we did it all on computer.
On that little Tascam laptop, with these mics and everything. And then James and Robin sort of came in at the same time and did all the... James did all the kind of lead parts and emphasis solos. Pop on the slides, though.
I didn't play any of the rhythm. I just did my solos and a few little bits here and there. So learning that all in the... That was the last thing we've learned. That was quite hard. And apart from that, it's not really that hard. My parts aren't. I just have to know when the changes are. I mean, that song's alright. It's not like Divided Sky, which is fucking well hard.
And Robin, it was more of a jam thing for him. Pumped some sections, but he got to have a bit more fun with it. And then, same with me. Me and Robin kind of jam along with that one.
Stick to your groove and kind of zone out and enjoy it. So you got to kind of think about it while you're playing.
Playing it is, you know, we've got to know when to come in, know when to start fading one bit out and another bit in.
It's very difficult to do live. It's so layered and all over the place. So we just tried to take the main parts from the song. The main rhythm.
It's fucking well hard, mate. What am I going to say? What was the question again?
Rare episodes. Right, here we go. Stay on. Are we still rolling?
Bands that like Zappa, like us, and play some of this stuff every now and then, or full-on cover bands. Andrew Greenaway put this CD together, Rare Episodes, of his unrecorded songs done by us, like we did Little Dots.
I'm going to have to blur that.
What?
Some nipples on it.
Some what?
Sorry. James swore all the way through.
So it's alright. Worth the purchase.
One of the best things about this gig is sort of up there in the biggest kind of players with Zappa.
Because it's a Zappa audience, they... By half the time we've played stuff, especially when we first started playing things, we turn up to play somewhere, play some weird stuff, and everyone would be like, what the fuck is this shit?
We've played places where they don't care, they just want drunken times. But
but now this is a Zappa crowd, they're going to like enjoy the kind of style we're doing and the oddness of it, because they know it.
And they know the Zappa tunes.
So I think it's going to be a better response than what we've had before. Apart from Muar, obviously. That was well good.
This audience would want to hear like good music, the musos and stuff. So we've got to be tight. So we've got to make it right. It's just going to be mad.
Do you want to go in the front hall, these things are like longest.
It's like way beyond my personal bubble. Nah.
Huh?
So good.
Just for you.
£1 fish.
£1, £2,
fish. There is a bar.
Ground floor.
Is this happening?
Doors closing.
No, it's
overloaded.
Look at your shoes.
Sit down for a long time. The entire time, I didn't find anywhere. That's room four. This is dressing room four, and that's dressing room three.
Hey, no!
We'll get this one. Love it.
Oh, these slide out. Chris. Boy, that's sliding. That's curtains.
It's
what? That's curtains.
Get that one.
That's been quite high up, isn't it?
Bring it up?
That's the one, we were still basically on the second floor.
Excuse me.
That's good about.
That's got philosophy on it. There we go. Right, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Bloody hell, this is more than two. This is unbelievable.
No, it's two.
Isn't that enough? We are so high up. Your second story in your house is not this hard.
Oh, that's the first one, probably.
Yeah. Who cares?
Whatever he wants.
Do what I want.
Kanye always hits people as well, doesn't he?
Who?
Kanye.
Yeah. Who's Kanye?
It's a talk show in America,
though. Oh, right.
That is ridiculous. Fucking Ike and Dave's.
Like sugar bait or some shit.
Nah, man. Get it right.